for the ingredients that we're feeding to our dogs and our cats, our pets, after the melamine scandal. Why should we trust them for what we're feeding our children now? That's organic today. Local, we know there's a cachet in local. At Walmart, they've increased their local purchases. Well, what's local at Walmart? Well, they're really proud to say that in Idaho, their technical definition is anything within the state is local. So the reason that they show such high numbers in on a national basis is in Idaho, their potatoes are local. In Wisconsin, their cheese is local. And in Florida, their oranges are local. They have a lot of local food at Walmart. At Whole Foods, now that's a bastion of high-end foodists, if you will. What's the definition of or a local in Walmart's? Walmart, Whole Foods, you know, it's a little problem. What's the definition of Whole Foods? Anything within 8 hours in a semi-trailer is local. Now, I don't know if it first gets shipped to a distribution point and then 8 hours to the store. But, you know, I'm sorry that anything, if you're talking about something from Southern Virginia and you're eating in Boston being organic, I'm not great at my geography, but I don't think that's organic. And the final issue I was going to bring up is we're talking about raw milk most of this week here, but raw almonds. We found out that the USDA very quietly passed a new law that said that all raw almonds had to be pasteurized. Well, what does pasteurized mean for almonds? Well, it means that because they're afraid of salmonella contamination on factory-scale, industrial-scale almond groves, that they are now either treating raw almonds. I'm going to get repetitive motion sickness here. Yeah. They're either treating raw almonds with a fumigant, propylene oxide, or they're treating it with heat. And when you go to the store, it still says raw. There's nothing on there, nothing to delineate that it was pasteurized. So those are some of the issues we're working at Cornucopia. If you have any questions or comments about anything I brought up or anything else in terms of food freedom, food sovereignty, I am armed with a microphone and I'm ready to come and see you and be certainly willing to entertain a few comments. Anybody have anything on their mind?